Tjena! Tjena. Välkomna till Klätterhuset!
In today's episode, we're at a place called Klätterhuset, where you can find some pretty awesome people and, well, just good times and good vibes. They recently hosted us from the national climbing team for a training week. And I just wanted to showcase a little bit of the gym because I found these LED lights just to be so freaking terrifically cool. And so, yeah, I just wanted to showcase it a little bit before we jump into the climbing. But as the title suggests, we're not entirely here to talk about Klätterhuset. We're going to watch some competition route climbing. And since I don't do much sport climbing, we're instead going to see Fredrik on the route, as well as this guy who's brushing the holds, and the wall in the background. His name is Hannes Puman, and he is a literal freak of nature when it comes to climbing. Okay, so you set the routes for the competitors. What was your base idea with everything? What did you have in mind when you set it?
I think in general, for the competition routes, it's maybe what is most different from gym routes is that they're really uncomfortable. It could be specific movements that are uncomfortable, or just situations that are a little bit weird off. I think for most climbers or athletes, they have a working time. In some particular cases, you can see that, okay, this guy has 3 minutes, but in general, they climb between 2.5 minutes and maybe 4.5 minutes. Hmm. And having a little bit weird route or force them to make decisions and take risks and so on is something they need to do to be able to climb the route within 4 minutes.
And the first route, approximately how hard is it with a range?
Yeah, it's really hard to say the grade, but my guess would be it's 8B plus.
Okay.
There's some holds are a little bit too good for the route, I would say.
Ready. Okay, so how would you describe a competition route? What is a competition route? Instead of like a regular gym route. Is it the same or is it different in your opinion?
It's a lot more about having a little bit of change up everywhere. As gym routes are, you try to get the flow when it's supposed to be comfortable and even. A competition route, you always have to throw like a little bit extra at some places, so mm-hmm. you keep the climbers, you know, not on autopilot, that you still have to make decisions.
Mm.
But it's still so hard that if you don't execute those small cruxes or whatever's getting thrown at you, you'll pump out.
Yeah.
Which basically means that even if you feel like you're gonna fall, it might still be worth it to just go for it and see what happens. Because if you hang there for too long and do it, you might just do 2 moves more. And if you make the choice that I'm just gonna go for it, you might fall, but you might do it, and then you might just do like 10 moves more.
Mm.
Who knows?
Nice. What did you say?
It's a lot of blood.
How would you describe Hannes Puma?
A good blend of like really, really, really top-end physical capabilities and a lot of experience in climbing. The amount of climbing he's done is more than most. Even if you think you climb a lot, he has climbed more. That makes the climbing style. The climbing style is smart. It's kind of low risk, but not too much expenditure on energy. It's hard to say. I think it's he's a good roots climber. I don't know what more to say.
So in this episode, Hannes isn't going to be doing a lot of talking, so I figured out I could tell you a little bit about him instead, how he climbs. So first off, as I mentioned, he's a literal freak of nature. Last year he was in the World Championship Finals in lead, and I believe he did a 9A route on the second go. He's also insanely strong at bouldering, and he will be competing in the combined category in the European Championship coming up next week for a place in the Olympics next year.
Let's get in, deadly, deadly.
Did it go as you expected?
Yeah, maybe. I think Fredrik had a quite tough situation with a tape on leading fingers, so it wasn't a fair result. With Hannes, it looked a little bit too easy from time to time.
Mm-hmm.
In particular, there was one jug in the middle. I tried to find a two-finger pocket so you could actually do the cross instead. But to be honest, I didn't find a good hole to put there, so it ended up with a bad decision of leaving that hold. Also on the top, when I tried it, I got really tired up there.
Mm.
When he climbs it looks a little bit too easy, the holds look like jugs.
Yeah.
So I think that was a good lesson also. I need to get back at setting harder roots again.
Okay, so after you fell off the first route, what did you have in mind? What was next?
I climbed like shit. that was about it.
Could you explain? Because I mean, I looked at the footage, and I think everyone who watches this is gonna be like, "No, you didn't. You look super strong." So, like, why was it that made you climb like shit, or in what way do you mean?
It's a feeling. Sometimes, even if you top a route, you can feel, I climb bad. It's not so much about if you get up or if you don't. It's more about the feeling.
Mm.
And the feeling was super bad. there's like a lot of pieces to it. The way I used my feet didn't feel good. I felt tense. I didn't relax. I moved slowly. Like anything that could have gone, like I could have done bad, I kind of did bad.
Yeah.
And even if you don't see it, that's the way I feel it.
Mm.
That's
what matters. Yeah.
Yeah.
Nice. So after Hannes and Fredrik had tried the route, they changed a little bit at the top, and Fredrik was really stoked to give the route another burn, with the sole focus to be more in the zone and to climb more controlled. All my life I've barely spoken. Your words have been so broken. I've been under your hypnosis. Why did I sip that potion? I'm so done with holy ghosting. My birth, it is an omen. Lay me down up in the ocean until you see no motion. Right now I can barely focus. I'm showing no emotion. On your knees, show your devotion. My skin is black but golden. I'm not here for bragging, boasting. Ain't lying, I've been chosen. Mind is burning, heart's exploding. This is my man. Are you with me now? Said, are you with me now? Ain't felt this good in a while. They want us to simmer down. Can you hear me now? Am I going in and out? I stop and just look around to see if you're with me now. Tell me, are you with me now? Ready to put it down. Start at the bottom, already forgot them, but they won't forgive me now. You really ain't ready now. You hit it just in the crowd. But still I just look around, are you with me now? Are you with me? Step in the fire, get ready to take it higher. Real coming out your amplifier. Y'all want every black man to be rich and proud. Why these white boys up and turn into shy, huh? Cell phone became your brother. Internet replaced your mother. You leaving homies on red.
Yeah.
So wonder all your friends dead. Jealousy was a centerpiece. So my best friends turn to enemies. Sabotage my identity. Why they want to treat me like a Kennedy? They want to affect the legacy. Protect it hard, I cut off the extremities. I'll never be another piece in your recipe for social supremacy. Are you with me now? Said, are you with me now? Ain't felt this good in a while. They want us to simmer down. Can you hear me now? Am I going in and out? I stop and just look around to see if you're with me now. Tell me, are you with me now? Ready to put it down. Start at the bottom, already forgot them, but they won't forget.
Yeah, come here, Fred.
You
really ain't ready now. You haters, you send the crowd. But till I just look around, are you with me now? Are you with me now? Are you with me now? Said, are you with me now? They felt this good in a while. They want us to simmer down. Can you hear me now? Am I going in and out? I stop and just look around. See if you're with me now. Tell me, yeah, you're with me now. Ready to put it down. Start at the bottom, already forgot them, but they don't forgive me now. You really ain't ready now. You haters just in the crowd. But still, I just look around. Are you with me now? Are you with me now? Whoa, whoa. I feel it coming now. It's too late to shut up. Stop.
over the mountain now. Burning the valley down. I don't know where my mind is. Don't even know what time is. Somebody stop the virus. Room full of bodies, but nothing but silence. Yeah, I'm quiet, but all that shine is. Go crazy, turn this bitch into an asylum. You fly, but we ain't looking for pilots. I never bow down to a tyrant, it's highness. Even Jack said, fuck all them giants. What goes up comes down, man, that's basic science. Look at my iris and you'll see the fines. I'd rather not get involved with you. What's the problem, man? I solve all your sign. How you find when your time up? How you climb when your line stuck? Barbershop getting lined up. Yeah, your head good, but your mind super clear, Uber everywhere. This sound like Superman is here. Are you with me now? Said, are you coming now? We got this good in the wild. They want us to simmer down. Can you hear me now? Am I going in and out? I stop and just look around to see if you're with me now. Tell me, are you with me now? Ready to put it down. Start at the bottom, already forgot it, but they won't forgive me now. You really ain't ready now.
Come on, Freddy. The man, the myth, the legend. How's your fingers?
Not very good. These two have holes.
Yeah.
And this one have a good hole. This one was bleeding a little bit, but it's not now. This one managed to stay alive.
Yeah.
These are okay. It keeps like dripping out a little bit.
Yeah. Here.
But it was worth it. Much better than the first try.
Nice.
Du vet att vi kommer att avsluta med en klassisk brottningsmatch.
Det brottas ut i bilden.
Kul att ni har kollat på Emils video.
Håller med. Fortsätt titta på alla andra också.
Ja, kom ihåg att likea,
subscriba
och följ och kommentera där nere. Algoritmen.
Ja, just det.
High five, high five. Nu.
Quick bet, who's gonna win it?
Det där är bara en tap.
Min maxspärr blev dubbel nu. Jag hörde det där.
Såg du vilken swing?
Det var bra.